So friends, our next topic is transom floor. This is another important question under second mix oral for function 3. Now let's see how is the diagram of transom floor and how you are supposed to draw it. So this is what is your stern frame. As you can see over here, this is the stern frame what I'm drawing, and this is the stern tube. This is the propeller. Okay, let's draw a rudder over here. So we have a rudder over here. Let's connect this rudder. Okay, this is an important axis to keep in mind. This is the rudder stroke. Now, this is your rudder stock. So let's do the naming. This is your stern frame. This is a double plate rudder. Now this post, the post connecting the stern frame to the rudder is called the rudder post. This post is your rudder post. And this post, the post which is connecting the stern frame to the propeller is called the propeller post. These are the flows. Now the flow which connects the rudder post, this flow, the post, the flow which connects the rudder post is called your transom flow. Okay, now this transom flow is much heavier in stiffening compared to the adjacent flows. Compared to this floor over here, this structure what you are seeing is the vibration post. Now the function of vibration post is to reduce the vibration at this turn. Okay, now the transom floor, it supports the framework of the stern. Okay, it supports the framework of the stern structure, and it provides strengthening to the stern. As well as your transom flow, it is much more stiffened compared to the adjacent flows, and the depth of the transom flow is equivalent to the depth of the flows in the cellular double bottom. So this is all about your transom flow.